největší kariérní výzva pro jednoho, koruna šampiona a sláva pro druhého. Československý souboj o to nejcennější. Pás šampiona ve střední váze.
V hlavě se mi rodí dvě různé taktiky, buď to ukončit jako velice rychle, anebo prostě toho piráta šikanovat, drtit ho a ukázat mu, že tam je ten večer jako špatně. V oktagonu není jen jeden král, v oktagonu je nový král.
S Kličom, kvůli tomu, že si dostal bitku o titul v KSV a teraz jsem dojel, že povedal, že si nový král. Čím má se ukončit, jakým úderom, jakým KO, čo on nemá KO úder. Obavím si ten pás a zoberiem si domov ďalší pás a vôbec nemám žiadne obavy z neho.
Ja ho chytím, uderím. A bude po zápase.
Lístky v síti Ticketportál a živě na octagon.tv.
But now he resides in Alaska.
Matavau, tvrdý borec, ktorý šokoval mnohých divákov v zápase s Pirátom tvrdými ranami a ešte tvrdšou bradou.
Je zrovna vysoký na váhu 84 kg, ale paradoxne si verí v postoji.
Ale rozhodne na nic nečeká, podívej sa, aké má bomby, je dobrý boxer. Tvrdý rámky, kamaráde.
Al Matavau sice s Pirátem prohral, ale svým přístupem a stylem boje si okamžite získal veľkou pozornosť fanoušků. Pavel Salin Salčák nepije, športuje, zdravo sa stravuje, pôsobí skoro až ako zenový bojovník. Na svojom konte má titul šampióna Česka v tajskom boxe.
Držitel stále nejrychlejšího KO oktagonu měl na svém kontě šňůru 4 vítězství, o kterou však v posledním duelu přišel.
Tak Salina Salčáka je to možno najtvrdší super jeho kariéry. Matavau je agresor vo svojich zápasoch. On je ten, kto do toho väčšinou vletí hneď zo štartu a otvorí zápas. Salin je naopak opatrný, čo sa rozbieha pomalšie, taktickejšie a skôr prenáša súboj na zem. Koho taktika nakoniec zvíťazí?
Welcome to our main card, guys, here in your commentary box. Luke Barnett, joined by my tough 17 brother, Mr. Kelvin Gastelum.
Hey.
We're here now looking at Pavel Salin Salchak on his way to the cage, a veteran of the Octagon Challenge show and has spent most of his career here at Octagon. Bit of a mixed record, you know, 5-5-1. And from that, he feels like the sport's not been great for him. He's a bit zen, a bit relaxed. He's not had the best career. He enjoys fighting, but feels like he's lost the passion for it a little bit. You know, like the fire's not been there.
Yeah.
And then when he was offered this fight, he said, all right, let's do it. I fancy this one. You know, I feel like this will be my last fight here in the cage.
Okay.
So it's kind of like his retirement bout.
I see, yeah.
He's from Ostrava, so this was supposed to be in his hometown until the COVID restrictions has to move us here to Brno. So a bit sad for him, but still great that he gets the opportunity to compete and show his level and show his, you know, he's been fighting for a very long time in Thai boxing. And he's a nice guy, great person. Feels like taking on Al Matavau is a great opponent for him to end his career on. And then he wants to make friends with him so he can go visit American Samoa in the future. You know, make relationships. And the best way to make friends is to have a cage fight.
Have a fist fight with somebody. Become best friends. The American Samoans, they're a race of people that are known for just being big, strong people, you know? And so I see his highlights and he throws bombs, bro.
Yeah, fighting is bred within him. You can see that, strangely enough, comes from, as you can see, the flag, American Samoa, and now living in Alaska.
So took himself to Alaska. I don't know why, we'll have to ask him.
I know quite a bit of people that have been out to Alaska and trained there, and there's fights there. There's an Alaskan league there. I'm not sure the name of it, but I do know there's some MMA activity going on out there.
Yeah, so maybe following his dream out there, knowing he can get good training. They're moving out from Samoa, American Samoa, Al Matavo. He's, like you said, from his highlight reel, very, very explosive athlete, very physically strong, likes to come forward and look for takedowns, as well as throw heavy, heavy bombs.
Absolutely. I don't think this fight will go all three rounds.
And this guy's all action. He's coming off a few losses, you know, had a tough run,
mm-hmm.
Two or three losses on the bounce. So this is a nice fight for him to, you know, to re-stamp his career, restart. If he could convert it, taking on Pavel, who's obviously coming to the end of his career, said pre-fight, I mean, I'm not sure about the mentality going into a fight, saying it's going to be your last fight.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's good for you or bad for you, but we'll find out.
We will find out.
Al Matavo calls himself Sweetness, because he's a bit of a sugar addict.
Okay.
Chocolate. And here we see 28 years old in Sweetness taking on 37 in Salin Salchak.
Young buck.
Yeah, 28.
That's 37. I mean, yeah, I can see why he's thinking about maybe it being his last fight, you know.
Hanging up the gloves.
Panové, začíná hlavní karta turnaje Octagon 29 a to zápasem ve střední váze na 3 kola po 5 minutách. Vaším rozhodčím v Octagonu je Petr Balej. Pojďme si představit oba muže. Nejprve modrý roh, 37 let, 189 cm, 84,3 kg na váze. Reinders MMA tým pod trenérem André Reindersem nastupuje ke svému 12. profesionálnímu zápasu. Dosavadních 11 odcházel 5x jako vítěz. 2 KO, 5 porážek, 1 remíza. Za Česko, držitel nejrychlejšího KO v historii Octagonu v modrém rohu, Pavel Salin Salchak! Červený roh, 27 let, 173 cm, 84,8 kg. Legacy Jiu-Jitsu pod trenérem Jordanem Controu, Jason Novelim a Sharonem McKenzie. Má na svém kontě 12 zápasů, 8 vítězství, 6 KO a pouze 4 porážky. Z Aljašky a Samoji, v červeném rohu, Al Matavo!
Gentlemen, there are no rules. Fight hard, fight fair, fight for win. Touch your gloves, step back.
Here we go. Kicking off the pay-per-view.
Pavel Salchak representing Ostrava in the blue corner, wearing the white shorts with yellow trim. Taking Al Sweetness Matavao. Touch of gloves and here we go. Can just see the power possessed by the Samoan.
Well, let's see what the Zen Warrior is bringing today.
You know, a lot of Thai experience in the corner of Pavel Salchak.
Switching up stances, Salchak is. He was southpaw, now he's orthodox.
Yeah, dangerous on the feet. I feel like Sweetness is going to look to rush in, throw that heavy bomb and of an overhand left, and look for these takedowns. Trains predominantly at a jiu-jitsu gym over in Alaska. He just looks cocked and ready to go.
Yeah, they're just... He's just waiting. Trying to find an opening. Unload those bombs that he's got clocked and ready to go.
Oh, there was one, a swing and a miss. Bada, 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 swing.
Yeah, you could see speed, power with it. little low kick.
You know, Salchak's got lots of tricks in the bag, lots of tools. Good stand-up fighter. You can see that by his movement, controlling the distance.
Yeah, you can see his Thai experience, the way he moves, his stance.
Backing up in straight lines, though, straight into the fence. As the Samoan Sweetness comes forward.
Ooh,
nice little elbow.
Yeah, he ran into that, didn't he?
Interesting fight, this.
He switched stances, the Samoan did.
Yes, back to orthodox.
Back to orthodox. They're both changing it up on each other. Giving each other different looks here.
Short, stout, explosive. His Sweetness.
Reminds me of someone.
Yeah, I know a guy like that. Heavy in the bomb half, throws heavy, big back. Yeah, I know a guy like that. Switches to southpaw.
Hey.
Ooh, nice inside kick.
Whoa!
Wow. Lovely jumping knee. Told you he's got tricks in the bag.
Yeah, that was beautiful. Nice little flying knee.
But the breeze block head of the Samoan.
Now he's got him thinking about that, you know? Salchak is just tall enough, too. He just just puts his knee up and it's there in Matavao's face.
I know a guy like that.
Yeah.
No takedown attempt so far from Matavao, though. Happy to keep this standing, keep that distance. He's good control apart from that flying knee. He's been doing great work.
Yeah, no, he seems to be pretty content here. Looking for his own little knockout.
Beautiful little switch there, three south, stepped in.
Tricky.
Long limbs. From Pavel Salchak.
Yeah, I'd like to see him kind of utilize that long reach that he has.
I feel like the knees and the elbows are where Salchak comes to life, you know, in that space, that jumping knee, little flick elbow, like the Thai style stuff, rather than like the kickboxing.
I see, yeah, you're totally right on that.
And Matavao has got to be extremely careful when he gets in that range, and that which is the range he needs to throw the bombs, you know, that puncher's range. Got to be careful. Salchak doesn't lift up a knee.
Nice body kick there by Matavao.
Big swings. Lance coming forward as well.
Got to be careful just coming in like that. He's going to run into stuff like that. Boom. Samoan trying to work his way in.
Nice little shots on the inside from both guys. Salchak trying to run.
Oy.
The cage is in the way.
Beautiful uppercut there at the end.
Yeah, it's almost like it woke him up, though, and he come flying back with a knee.
Yeah.
Back and forth. You only saw the real aggression. They said he's a Zen warrior, very calm.
Right.
When he got clipped with that big shot.
It woke him up for sure.
He didn't look calm then. I saw rage in his eyes as he threw that right knee.
Yeah, right. His eyes turned red for a second.
See the mark, though, on Pavel's face, on that nose. He's been caught good. Rung his bell, definitely. Here's that.
Boom.
Running knee attempt. And that was beautifully placed. It was just because Sweetness was moving back at the same time. The Samoan wasn't coming forward into the knee. He was running from it. They're not so aggressive. Big shot there. This is the end of the round.
Boom.
Where probably Sweetness got the most success he's had the whole fight.
Boom, boom. That was a beautiful lead uppercut there. And we saw the red in the eyes of Salchak. Second round coming in for these guys.
Beautiful movement from Matavao.
Nice combo there.
Explosive speed, fast, twitching. Good style, nice overhand. And again, drops him.
Oh, he dropped him. Now he's going in for a takedown. Matavao, he's hurt.
Big shots.
He's hurt. He's done.
This could be it, covering up for Pavel Sawczak. Sweetness to Samoan, pouring it on.
Ooh, he's not so sweet right here.
And it's over. Sweetness.
Sweetness.
The Alaskan, the Samoan from Alaska, finds a home for that right hand and then was relentless. Constant shots, drew blood, come forward, throwing shots. And once it hit the ground, was just non-stop on top.
I find it hard to believe anybody would survive those kind of punches. I mean, this guy was throwing bombs. Like we said, it didn't go the full three rounds. It didn't even go the full second round.
I feel bad for Pavel Sawczak, you know, coming here, last fight, gonna retire after that, and maybe that's a sign that he should, 37 maybe. Years old. But this moment belongs to Al Matavao. Sweetness. Can go have all the candy, all the chocolate he wants now. No way to be made. And they will be celebrating in American Samoa.
As they should. They got a great rising contender here.
Pavel Sawczak back on his feet. A cheer and a pop from the crowd, a show of respect. And they're taking him for medical attention. A lot of blood coming from the blunt force trauma.
Oh, my.
Of the Samoan.
The medics came and got him, huh? He must be really
feeling it. And here we get a look at the end of the fight. I feel like Sweetness just came out with a little bit more pop in the second round, a little bit more aggression.
Yeah.
And then when he landed his left hand, he smelled blood, and he went after it. These big elbows to the head. This is what ended the fight, really. And then he was non-stop. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Technickým kolem, technickým KO vítězí Al Sweetness Matavao. Ještě předtím samozřejmě, než dám prostor Alovi, tak mnozí z vás to věděli, někteří možná ne. Tohle byl poslední zápas Pavla Sawczaka Salina a určitě si to představoval jinak. Chtěl položit rukavice do středu oktagonu a tím dát najevo, že tahle ta kapitola jeho života je zavřena. Pavel je tamhle v rohu na šití. Myslím, že si zaslouží od nás obrovské poděkování a od vás obrovský potlesk. Budeme se vídat dál. Jsou věci, které si v životě představujete jinak, ale naplánovat se nedají, nedá se nic dělat. So Al, I don't know if you know this, nevím, jestli toho věděl, máme tady slečnou překladatelku, ale byl to poslední zápas Pavla Sawczaka.
Yes, I knew that was his last fight, so I wanted to make it a fun fight for him, but sucks they happen this way. So I give props for him for stepping into the cage.
Ano, vím, že to byl jeho poslední zápas, chtěl jsem, aby to pro něj byla zábava, ale dopadlo to, jak to dopadlo.
No, zábava to nebylo, jak jsi mu to mohl udělat?
It was no fun.
Every time I step in the cage, I always try to make a fun fight, so that's always the game plan.
Ano, vždy, když jdu do klece, tak chtěl, aby to byla show pro diváky a zábavná podívaná.
Určitě to tak bylo. Děkujeme moc samozřejmě za zápas a doufáme, že tě ještě někdy uvidíme. Je někdo v žebříčku, kdo by tě zajímal třeba v příštím zápase?
It's my first win after a long losing streak, so I'm trying to, I'll climb up the ladder. I know Pirate's fighting for the title soon. Good luck to my friend Pirate for the December 30th, so I hope you get that belt, my friend.
Teď je to moje první výhra po dlouhé době a teď budu doufám zase stoupat pomalu v žebříčku. Vím, že brzo bude bojovat Pirát, to je můj kamarád, tak mu držím palce, aby si 30. prosince aby to vyhrál.
Přesně tak, aby získal ten titul. Děkujeme moc, thank you very much, it was sweetness again. Alma Tavel.
Jeden z nejočekávanějších střetů v kleci, jaký OKTAGON kdy zažil. Odložené finále OKTAGON Underground dvou československých rivalů.
Nepřemýšlí, nic neřeší, vypustí všechno, co v sobě má. A myslím si, že to není úplně nejlepší styl.
Matěj Many Peňáz. V kleci dosud smetl vše, co se mu dostalo do cesty. Tvrdý slovenský bijec poháněný srbskou krví. Vlasto El Chapo Čepo.
Nebojím se ničeho, jdem tam prostě na všechno.
Takže Matějka, jdeme rozměnit na drobné, jako jsem hovoril.
Já si myslím, že mě nikdo nerozmění na drobný, že jsem velká bankovka.
Rozjetý Matuš Juráček dostal přesně to, o co si řekl. Diamantového čáva z Bratislavy, Roba Pukače. Obávaný denverský grizzly Jeremy Kimball se konečně vrací. A bude čelit španělské KO mašině Danielu Toledovi. Splácet dluhy ve jménu svého gymu se chystá super talent Tichota. Po skalpu Růžičky a Gabala je na řadě mladý polský kat David Kareta. A chybět nebudou. Královna undergroundu Teresa Bledá. Dvojka žebříčku lehké váhy Ronald Ronny Paradeiser. Bajný německý kelt Christian Jungwirth. Nezastavitelná šampionka výzvy Lucia Sabová. Nebo záruka těch nejatraktivnějších zápasů. Miroslav Inquisitor Bros. Jubilejní OKTAGON 30 v brněnském Bobby centru. Lístky v síti Ticketportál nebo živě na oktagon.tv.